Hello everyone. So in the earlier videos we had discussed about the linkage. So in linkage we had discussed about the complete linkage, which occurs generally in case of the Drosophila, especially male Drosophila. In the complete linkage, the genes which are involved are the linked genes, and there is no crossing over, which means there are only the parental generations are being observed in that of the F1 or F2 generations. And we had even discussed about the dihybrid ratio in the complete linkage, where it was 3:1 and the dihybrid test cross ratio was 1:1 instead of 1:1:1:1. Okay. So in today's video, we'll be discussing about incomplete linkage. So that was complete linkage, and today's video is about incomplete linkage. So incomplete linkage is whenever there is a new individuals, which means the recombinants are being formed along with that of the parental generation. So that is where we call it as incomplete linkage. And incomplete linkage occurs due to crossing over. So whenever in the linked genes, as the distance between the two linked genes is extremely less, so there is no possibility of the crossing over to occur. So thereby there is no chance of the recombinants to be formed. But here there is the crossing over occurs between that of the chromosomes, due to which the recombinants are being formed along with the parental combinations. And the crossing over, okay, is directly proportional to that of the percentage of the recombinants which are being formed, which means if crossing over, if it is less, then there will be lesser the percentage of the recombinants. And if the crossing over, if it is more, then the percentage of the recombinants will be more, right? And the number of recombinants which are generally formed in incomplete linkage are usually less, okay, than that of the recombinants which are being formed according to the Mendelian law of independent assortment. So why it is so? Why the number of recombinants are usually less when compared to that of the recombinants formed in the independent assortment is, that is generally here, the segregation of the chromosomes may not occur as it is incomplete linkage. So the segregation of the chromosomes may not occur as it was there in that of the independent assortment. So thereby there is a chance that the number of recombinants which will be formed are generally lesser. And in some of the cases, what we can see is parental types will be generally more than 25%, whereas the recombinant percentage will be less than 25% in some of the instances. Okay. Thereafter is, for example, in case of incomplete linkage, whatever the Morgan had conducted the experiments, okay, that is also on the Drosophila, and later his students like Bridges as well as Alfred Stutterman, so they also started doing experiments on that of the Drosophila. So according to Bridges, in the year 1916, Bridges in the year 1916, so he did an experiment, that is a dihybrid test cross, where he selected two characters. First one is the eye color, and the second one was the normal wing, that is wing pattern. So when Bridges crossed red eyed normal winged females with that of the purple eyed vestigial winged males, so he got a completely different ratio, which was being completely deviating from that of the Mendelian dihybrid test cross ratio. Okay, so there the dihybrid test cross ratio was 1:1:1:1. But here, whatever the dihybrid test cross ratio was obtained by the Bridges, it was 9:1:1:8. So how that is possible? So we'll get into the cross here. Right. So when red-eyed normal winged females were crossed with purple-eyed vestigial wings, so this is the parental phenotype, and for this the parental genotype is capital PV and purple eye vestigial wing, so that is both are recessive characters, so thereby both the recessive alleles are being here. So both are being taken in a homozygous condition. So here these two are the homozygous dominant and here these are the homozygous recessive. So the gamete formation, as usual we used to do. So gamete formation, okay. So here it is PV and PV. So similarly here it is small p, small v. Okay, so these two are the sperms which are being produced and these two are the ova which are being produced by the females. Now whenever there is a cross, okay, between these two gametes, so in the F1 generation, the progeny which was being obtained, so that was capital P, small p, small v. So here what you can observe is the heterozygous condition. Because in the parents we have taken homozygous dominant is crossed with a homozygous recessive, in the F1 generation there is a formation of the heterozygous condition where the phenotype is again as red-eyed normal wing individuals who are being formed, okay, in the F1 generation. Now when the F1 generation was being test crossed, when the test cross was being done here, okay, so the F1 generation, that is capital P capital V small p small v, into the homozygous recessive parent, what we have to take here small p small v. Now if you look after the F1 gametes, okay, so this will be, so capital P, thereafter we have a capital V, capital P, small v, small p, capital V, and small p, small v. So these are the four gametes which are being formed over here, and in here, so there is the gamete, so that is small p, small v. So these are the gametes which are being formed, okay, in that of this F1 gametes of the homozygous recessive parent. So when the crossing was being done, over here, okay, so what the bridges obtained was, okay, F2 generation, we'll write over here. Okay. Next is, we'll take these gametes. Capital P, capital V, capital P, small v, small p, capital V, and small p, small v. And these gametes we'll take here. So that is small p, small v. So, we have a checkerboard. Here the male and female gametes, okay. So now when we cross, so capital P small p capital V small v, thereafter is capital P small p small vv, next is small pp capital V small v, and in the last one we obtain small pp small vv. So here let us write the phenotypes for these. So here you can see that the two dominant alleles are there for that of the eye color as well as for the wing pattern. So here these are red eye normal wing. Okay. Next is red eye vestigial wing. Next is this is purple eye the normal wing and the last one is purple eye vestigial wing. So this is what we have been made it as cut short. Okay, but whenever the Burgess did this experiment, he conducted by taking a large number of the offsprings, and when the results were being calculated, so there what he obtained was, so the normal wing were around the ratio what he obtained was 9:1:1:8. So where you can see that in the F2 generation, the normal wing and vestigial wing, so these are the parental characters. So these parental characters are more, okay na? So you can see the parental generation is more when compared to that of the recombinants. So recombinants, so vestigial wing and red-eyed vestigial wing and purple-eyed normal wing. So these are the two recombinants which are being formed, and the percentage of these recombinants was comparatively less when compared to that of the parental generation. So parental generation is more than 25%, and the recombinant percentage was very less, that is around, so here I will write the parental generation had around 90.7% of the parental characters were being seen in the F2 generation, while the recombinant percentage, okay, so that was around 9.3%, so which is generally lesser than that of 25%, and the ratio was being obtained was 9:1:1:8. So that was the observation made by the Burgess, where this ratio, okay, the phenotypic and genotypic ratio what Burgess had obtained was being completely deviating from the Mendelian dihybrid test cross ratio, where it was 1:1:1:1, but Burgess had obtained the ratio, that is 9:1:1:8. That probably proves that the genes which are being present on the chromosomes, so these chromosomes may not have been segregated independently. If they might have segregated independently, then the ratio in the F2 generation might be around 1:1:1:1. But as there is a failure in the segregation of the chromosomes completely, as there is an incomplete linkage, so there the ratio has been obtained, that is 9:1:1:8. So this is one of the example of the dihybrid test cross in the incomplete linkage that explains about the deviation of the Mendelian ratios what he had obtained. So that is not true with that of the Drosophila. Thank you.